the back sleepers. If you are one of the few who sleeps flat on your back, arms pinned to your sides like a soldier, or thrown up above your head like a starfish, congratulations. You have inadvertently stumbled upon the only position that orthopedists, chiropractors, and dermatologists actually agree on. They call this the Savasana Paradox. It is named after the final resting pose in yoga, the corpse pose. And there is a reason why every yoga session ends this way. Mechanically, you have hit the biological jackpot. Think about the physics of your day. For 16 hours, gravity is crushing you. It's compressing your vertebrae, hunching your shoulders, and curving your neck down toward your smartphone. But when the back sleeper lies down, they aren't just sleeping, they are resetting the machine. By letting gravity pull your shoulders down into the mattress and keeping your spine in a straight neutral line, you are essentially mimicking perfect posture but horizontally. There is no twisting, there is no crunching. It is the only position where your skeleton is perfectly at rest. But here is the hidden vanity hack that the beauty industry doesn't want to talk about. The back sleeper has a secret weapon against time, the anti-aging shield. It sounds like vanity, but it is pure physics. When you smash your face into a cotton pillow for 8 hours a night, every single night for 30 years, you are physically ironing wrinkles into your skin. We call these shear forces that break down collagen and create permanent creases that no amount of expensive cream can fix. But the back sleeper? Your face is floating in the air. Nothing is touching your skin. You are literally letting gravity smooth out your facial muscles while you dream. If you want to look 5 years younger than your friends when you hit 40, stop buying creams and start sleeping on your back. However, there is a price to pay for that perfect skin, and you pay for it with your breath. While gravity is being kind to your face, it is waging a brutal war on your airway. This is what they call the gravity trap. The moment you drift off, your tongue, which is actually a surprisingly heavy, fleshy muscle, loses its tension. Because you are on your back, gravity pulls that heavy tongue straight down into the back of your throat. For millions of people, this turns your windpipe from a wide-open tunnel into a pinched straw. This creates the turbulence we know as snoring. But for many, it goes much further. It triggers obstructive sleep apnea. This is where the walls of your throat actually collapse completely. You stop breathing, your oxygen levels crash, your brain panics, jolts you awake just enough to gasp for air, and then you fall back asleep. This happens hundreds of times a night. You think you slept for 8 hours, but your body just ran a marathon of suffocation, and it gets even darker. If you are a back sleeper, you are statistically more likely to experience one of the most terrifying psychological phenomena known to man, sleep paralysis. Throughout history, this has been called the old hag syndrome, or the incubus. You wake up, your eyes are open, you can see your room, but you cannot move a single muscle. And then, you sense a presence, a shadow in the corner, a weight sitting on your chest, crushing the air out of you. Why does this happen to the back sleeper? Because the supine position encourages the deepest form of muscle relaxation, known as atonia. But because your airway is restricted, your brain can glitch. It wakes up your consciousness before it turns your body back on. You are awake, but you are paralyzed, and your panicked brain starts to hallucinate a demon to explain why you can't breathe. So, the back sleeper's verdict is a heavy one. You will have a beautiful, aligned spine and a flawless, wrinkle-free face, provided you don't suffocate or hallucinate before your alarm goes off. The stomach sleepers. If you are a stomach sleeper, often called the free faller, you are fighting a nightly battle against your own anatomy. There is a reason why almost every chiropractor, physical therapist, and orthopedic surgeon begs you to stop doing this immediately. You might think you are just getting cozy, burying your face in the mattress to block out the world. But physically, you are subjecting your body to a slow-motion car crash 8 hours a night. Let's visualize the damage. I want you to imagine standing in line at the grocery store. Now turn your head to the left as far as it will possibly go. Hit that limit where the muscles get tight. Now hold it there. For 6 hours, that is exactly what you are doing to your cervical spine. Unless you have figured out how to breathe through a pillow, you have to twist your neck 90 degrees just to survive the night. Anatomically, you are wringing out your spinal cord like a wet towel. Let's zoom in on the vertebrae, the atlas, and the axis, right at the top of your neck. These delicate bones are designed for mobility, not sustained torque. When you lock them in that twisted position, you are compressing the facet joints. But worse, you are pinching the vertebral arteries. These are the vital pipelines supplying fresh blood to your brain. This is the biological reason why stomach sleepers so often wake up with headaches, a stiff neck, or that frantic pins and needles numbness in their hands. You aren't just sleeping wrong, you are kinking the hose to your own nervous system. And the destruction travels lower too. Most of us carry our weight in our midsection. When you lie face down, that weight sinks into the mattress. This creates the hammock effect. Instead of decompressing your discs, you are jamming them together. So this begs the question, if this position is a medieval torture rack for the spine, why on earth do we do it? Is there any redemption for the free faller? Surprisingly, yes, and it has to do with sound. If the back sleeper is the snorer, the stomach sleeper is the silencer. Remember that gravity trap we talked about earlier? The tongue falling back and choking the airway? Well, when you flip onto your stomach, you flip the physics. Suddenly, gravity becomes your ally. It pulls your tongue and soft palate forward, away from the back of your throat. The airway stays wide open. Mechanically, it is almost impossible to snore loudly on your stomach. In fact, this is so effective that before the invention of modern CPAP machines, doctors used to prescribe a brutal hack for patients with severe sleep apnea. They would sew a tennis ball into the back of the patient's pajama shirt. Why? So that if the patient rolled onto their back during the night, the pain of the tennis ball would force them to roll right back onto their stomach. It was a crude mechanical cure for suffocation. So here's the trade-off you are making every night. You will sleep silently and your partner will probably love you for it. You won't choke on your own tongue. But you are paying for that silence with the long-term health of your spine. You are trading a noisy night for a crippled neck. The side sleepers. If you sleep on your side in the fetal position like a baby, you are part of the majority. Roughly 69% of the human population sleeps this way. It is the most common position on Earth. And for years, scientists wondered, why did evolution push 3/4 of the human race to sleep on their sides? It turns out, the crowd might actually be right. Side sleeping isn't just comfortable, it is a biological necessity for the maintenance of your brain. They call this the brain's rinse cycle. A few years ago, researchers at Stony Brook University uncovered something incredible. It's called the glymphatic system. Think of it as your brain's night shift janitorial team. Here's the reality. Your brain is a metabolic engine. All day long, while you are thinking and working, your neurons are producing waste products. The most dangerous of these is a sticky protein called amyloid beta. This is the specific plaque that builds up and clogs the brains of patients with Alzheimer's and dementia. Studies using MRI scans showed that when you lie on your side, the clearance of this waste is significantly more efficient than on your back or stomach. While you dream, your brain cells actually shrink slightly to open up gaps, allowing cerebral spinal fluid to rush through and flush those toxins out. If you want to protect your memory as you age, the lateral position is your best defense. You are physically scrubbing your brain clean. But there is a massive catch, and it comes down to which side you choose. In the world of sleep, left and right are not created equal. If you suffer from heartburn or acid reflux, gravity is about to become your best friend or your worst enemy. Your stomach is not a symmetrical bag. It is shaped like a kidney bean, and it curves naturally to the left side of your body. When you sleep on your right side, the enter valve of your stomach is positioned below the level of your stomach acid. Gravity forces the acid to leak out and pool in your esophagus. You are essentially marinating your throat in digestive fluid all night. This is why you wake up with that burning chest pain. But roll onto your left side? The physics changes instantly. The stomach hangs naturally in a bowl shape. The acid stays safely pooled at the bottom, and the valve to your throat stays high and dry, well above the liquid line. It is a simple mechanical fix that works better than some medications. So, the left side is the undisputed champion? A clean brain and a happy stomach? Not entirely. While your internal organs are celebrating, your skeletal system is suffering. When you sleep on your side, you are crushing your entire body weight into one narrow point of contact, your shoulder. You are jamming the head of your humerus bone into the socket. Beneath that bone lies the brachial plexus, a complex superhighway of nerves that runs from your neck down to your fingertips. Compress that highway for 6 hours and you cut off the signal. This triggers the dreaded dead arm phenomenon. You know the feeling. You wake up in a panic because your arm feels like a cold, heavy piece of meat that doesn't belong to you. That isn't just falling asleep, that is nerve asphyxiation. And finally, we have to talk about vanity again. Just like the stomach sleeper, the side sleeper is smashing half their face into a pillow. But because of the angle, the pressure is even higher. This creates deep, vertical creases known as sleep wrinkles. Dermatologists can often tell which side you sleep on just by looking at your face. If you have deeper lines on your left cheek than your right, you are a left side sleeper. And unlike expression lines, which go away when you relax your face, these are structural. You are folding your skin like an envelope, night after night. So, the verdict? You have a detoxified brain and perfect digestion, but you might wake up with a numb arm and a folded face. If you're learning anything, hit that subscribe button right now so you won't miss the next episodes. Here is the hard truth that most sleep doctors won't tell you. Changing your primary sleep position is almost impossible. It is a subconscious habit ingrained in your neural pathways since childhood. If I tell a lifelong stomach sleeper to suddenly sleep on their back, they will stare at the ceiling for 2 hours, get frustrated, and flip over the second they lose consciousness. Your body will always revert to its default setting. So, the goal isn't to fight your nature. The goal is to hack it. We can neutralize the dark side of every position we just discussed using one simple tool. It's not a fancy gadget or an expensive mattress. It is the secondary pillow. Let's break down the physics of the pillow strategy. First, for the back sleepers. Your enemy is the arch in your lower back. When your legs are completely flat on the mattress, your hip flexors are pulled tight. This tension yanks your pelvis forward and creates a gap between your lower spine and the bed. That gap is where back pain is born. Place a firm, cylindrical pillow or a rolled-up towel directly underneath your knees. Instantly, you will feel your pelvis rotate back and your lumbar spine flatten completely against the mattress. You are turning a tension-filled arch into a neutral, supported line. Next, the side sleepers. Your enemy is rotation. When you lie on your side, gravity pulls your top leg forward and down toward the mattress. This acts like a lever. It twists your pelvis, which twists your lumbar spine, which torques your lower back. It's a slow-motion wringing of your vertebrae. You must sleep with a pillow sandwiched between your knees. This pillow acts as a mechanical spacer. It keeps your knees hip-width apart. It prevents that top leg from sliding forward, keeping your hips stacked perfectly vertically. It stops the spinal twist before it even starts. And finally, the stomach sleepers. This is the most critical one. Your enemy is the hammock effect, your heavy midsection sinking into the mattress and bending your spine backward into a U-shape. You don't need a pillow for your head, you need one for your hips. Take a thin, flat pillow and slide it under your pelvis. You are essentially turning a torture rack into a safe surface. One final variable, the head pillow. Most people buy pillows based on how soft they feel. That is a mistake. You need to buy based on geometry. If you are on your back, your pillow must be thin. If it's too thick, it forces your chin onto your chest, closing your airway and causing that snoring we talked about. You want your neck neutral. If you are on your side, you need the opposite. You need a pillow with high loft. It needs to be thick enough to fill the exact gap between the tip of your ear and the edge of your shoulder. If it's too thin, your head drops. If it's too thick, your neck cranes up. You aren't just buying comfort, you are buying spinal alignment. So, after dissecting the anatomy, the neurology, and the physics, who actually wins the silent lottery? If we look strictly at the data, the awards are clear. The back sleeper takes the gold medal for vanity. If your priority is preserving your face and aligning your spine, this is your king, provided you can handle the demons of sleep paralysis. The side sleeper takes the gold medal for longevity. Between the brain detoxification and the digestive benefits, this is the position that most likely helps you live longer, even if it costs you a numb arm. And the stomach sleeper? You take the gold medal for silence. It is the most selfless position, saving your partner's sleep at the expense of your own neck. But here is the final, unscientific truth. The perfect position is useless if you cannot actually fall asleep in it. Sleep debt is more dangerous than a wrinkle or a stiff neck. If you force your body into a perfect shape that keeps you awake all night, you are doing more damage than good. So, your goal tonight isn't to force a total transformation. It is to make that one small micro-adjustment. Grab that extra pillow. Anchor your knees. Support your hips. Hack the position you already love. Now, I want to see the demographics of who is watching this right now. We are going to take a census in the comments. Are you team back, team side, or are you a diehard team stomach? Scroll down, leave your vote, and maybe share this with a friend who snores a little too loud. I'll see you in the next video. Sweet dreams.